designer's budget, and our foundation grant will be around $7,300, so we'll have trouble looking at not to the 2011-2012 budget. Special education steering committee is continuing to meet. We need to make sure that we pass the WISD special renewal of their village, otherwise we will be even in additional trouble, so I'll see if you can support that.
Mr. Booth? Section 5.
A few other things, enrollment, we understand, they were February, some kind of one student, which is still good, there are tokens. And another item that we need to...
I can't hear you down here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The mic, the hum was too loud, and it turns out the hum, unfortunately. But also, I have to voice out the...
Okay, now, well, then, you will be able to talk to your person. The minutes of the plan.
Any other committee reports?
Personnel committee, there's Matt. We discussed there a couple of personnel matters that the two ticker requirements that I am making to those. We also discussed the posting, and that's pretty much it for personnel committee. Policy committee also met. We will be meeting again next week on Wednesday. We will be finishing up section 5000, and moving on from there.
Any other committee reports? Technology that Monday, and we discussed a little bit of the Google applications that Tony wants to take us into, as well as the library panel, and its server names, and the maintenance period necessary to accomplish that. Any other? Under the athletic council, notice we haven't gotten a call from those on the committee because of Mr. Acker's busy schedule. But seeing that districts is now over, we get called today, anyone that the board know, and the community know, and the school. If you happen to see any activities going on in the softball field, they are putting up the flag in center field. And they are taking that from the money that they have raised, so it doesn't come out of the general fund, it doesn't cost us anything. So if you see any unusual stuff going on, that's what they're doing. They're laying concrete and putting flag in center field. Just wanted to let you know that. Under new and old business, we have acceptance of donation.
Mr. President, I move the board on board of education accept the donation of 300 plus books from City Mortgage Company of Ann Arbor to Holmes Elementary.
Support. It's been moved and supported that the board on board of education accept the donation of 300 plus books from City Mortgage Company of Ann Arbor to Holmes Elementary. Is anybody who represents from Holmes here? Ms. Jenkins?
Yes. Yeah, they brought over a couple weeks ago, notebooks for every child we can. We really appreciate it. They were just, they work with us on a project. That was one. They wanted to support us with the meeting, the March meeting.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Yes, under letter B, we have a reconfiguration update.
Well, good evening again. We're going to have to, for whatever reason, kind of switch this out a little bit for you because, as you saw on their presentation, the computer screen went dark. So we had a PowerPoint to go along with the update to kind of give you a feeling for what our town hall meetings are going to look like. We're going to have to improvise with that. We don't have projectors for some reason overheated. So we will just go ahead and go through the presentation. You've been updated a few times, so this is tweaked a little bit, so we'll go through, probably change the format just a little bit. I'll have Dr. Jones start with the process. And we have staff in the audience who have been a part of the reconfiguration committee. We have some board members, and they're also involved in town hall meetings. So they will interject as we go through if they feel the need when there needs something to be said. Is that correct, staff that's here, that if it's involved? In fact, if you're involved in the committee, if you wouldn't mind standing to the board to see you, we would appreciate that.
Sounds good.
I want to make sure that our community is very much aware of the fact that this is a team effort, that we are working on this together, and that we are committed to this, knowing that the endeavor that we are headed toward is about what is best for our students. So with that, Dr. Joe, why don't you go through the process a little bit, and then I'll go back to the conclusion.
Thank you. Good to see you all. I understand that our community did a great job last time. I think that's here explaining it. And then go through the policies and make some comments. We started with a group of teachers and staff members, approximately 25 people. The first meeting was very fast, actually. I was just trying to run the rules and regulations. I thought maybe the second or third meeting we look at different options. Everybody was ready to move next option. Just moving very fast. The first night, actually, we came up with 6-7 different options. So let's go, let's just start this option, come back next time. And if there are more options, we'll put them together. So next time, we had a very in-depth discussion about all the options. There were a couple board members who were in and out of the meeting, and some of them, and they were there. And then what we did, basically, the process, the committee gave us two options by administration. We shared those options with the staff, and we were ready to make a presentation. And we made a presentation 2 weeks ago, and we're making another one today. Now we're in the process of meeting with the parents. We had one parent meeting last night. We'll have four or five next time. That's in your nice handout. Let's call Mr. Omega. He's here. Just the volunteer to do that, by the way, and everyone together. He did a wonderful job in short notice.
And with that brochure, if you look at the down in the middle section where there are the four different learning centers, the teachers that are in that level, they're the expert in that level, they actually wrote something related to the learning centers and submitted it to him, and then he printed the brochure. So you can see that this is a team effort. What was really nice about that is as they've been hearing us come to the buildings and talking about the vision that we have and where we want the district to go, and also just meeting with them, well, meeting at the buildings, they have actually heard the message, so it must be being articulated to the point where they understand it and believe and are committed to it, because those were their words. And so I was very proud to know that they are really a part of this process.
Just emphasizing that was a staff leader. All administration needed was support and facility. And they was basically asking for all staff members. The team process again, we had about five times, 20 to 25 members. We did evaluate the spaces, everybody had a floor plan. As I mentioned, we had six great possibilities. We evaluated the option. We reached consensus, and consensus was that everybody had a chance to speak their mind, and eventually two of the options came as a recommendation, and we made a presentation of those two options for the presentation. And the two options that we discussed. The two options are on page 3. The first option talks about two buildings, which have 3K to third grade, two building of 4 and 7, 4 to 7, and building of 8 to 12. Before we met, we said the vision that our superintendent had, that we want to be able to all of our kids to be successful. We have a chance to